Hey guys, what's going on? Dan the Man coming at you from the 60s Rule Channel. And yeah, before we get going here with the update, I just want to wish our friend and our brother Mark Batson a speedy recovery. Everybody knows what happened to Mark. He had a terrible spill there. And Mark, if you're watching this video, we're all pulling for you. And you know, get well soon, man. We want you back at the bench and making those cool videos, all right? And yeah, we got a Christmas card in today. Cool, huh? Yeah. For my buddy Frank Frizzo and family from Dan the Man. Frank, thank you so much, buddy. I really appreciate it, man. Frank's a real cool guy. He's got an awesome channel. You should go check him out. I had the privilege of meeting him at the Mosquito Con last year. And me and him and David Chin and Chris Donaton, we're all hanging out. We had a blast at that show. And Frank, we're going to do it again this year. I know we're going to have another good time down there. So, Frank, thank you so much for the Christmas card. And it's going to have a special place for all these Christmas cards from the community in my living room. So thank you so much for the card, brother. All right, what do we got going on over here? We got an update on the 50 Ford wagon. While I was waiting for the primer to come in, because you know the mishap I had with the primer, I figured I'd get the interior and the engine done. So let me show you the engine. We got that flathead done. And I don't know if you can see this or not. This camera's acting kind of funky. But, yeah, we finished that. We got it wired and plumbed. I don't think it wants to focus today. So, let me try something else. Oh, there we go. How's that? A little more detail there. There you go. And, you know what I did? I hit the whole thing with silver, you know, including the tranny. And I was using this guy here. I'm going to use on the body, the copper pearl. And I hit the heads. They were chrome, and I figured, let me try something different. So I hit the heads. Let me see if I can get a little more light on it there. I don't know. See if that works. Yeah, so, yeah, I shot that over the heads, and I got this nice effect in it. It looks pretty cool. So we got the fuel lines in there. We got the spark plug wires going on. And on the other side, I tried creating my own throttle linkage. I don't know if you could see that, but we got used pins, and I had some brass brackets laying around in my watch parts box. And see, there's a little hole in the back bracket there. That's going to go to, from that bracket, it's going to go to the firewall. So, yeah, it's basically all done there. And I just got to put the dump tubes on there. I got these dump tubes that came with the kit, and I cleaned them up. So we're going to use these dump tubes. They're going to go something like this over here. They're going to attach to the manifold. And then once that's done, I'll paint them up. And once the engine's installed in the chassis, then we'll run some maybe solder or something like that all the way back. Or maybe we'll put side pipes. I don't know yet, so. But, yeah, that came out pretty nice. I'm really happy with it. So far, so good. And we got the interior done. Worked on this a couple days. So, remember I told you guys I used those two-tone craft paints. We got the Canyon Orange. We got, what's the other one? Orange Spice. And then I did the pleats and Honey Brown. And then for the carpeting, I don't know how well that's coming up there, if you can see that. I use this material. My wife gave me this. I don't know. It's not a felt, but it's very flexible, and it's very thin. So it worked out very well, you know. And it looks just like carpeting, like flocking, you know. So, yeah, it came out really nice. And then we got the dash done. And I did the gauges. I hit the dials with, it's a white gel pen, and then I got this black watercolor pen to highlight the numbers on the gauges. Not bad. So far, so good. And the TV in the back there, it's Actually, there's an image on it, so I did the same thing. I hit the screen over here with the same white gel pen and then colored in that. It's like a little image of a car or something. So looks like something's going on the TV there. Yeah, and we got the seat belts. I threw them in the back there. So we got those done in semi-gloss black and use a chrome pen for the buckles. And yeah, she's looking pretty good so far. Pedals are all in there. That's all done. And the only thing left, I got the steering column. I couldn't find the steering column in the box. I don't know if it was thrown out accidentally or if it didn't come with it. But I got a piece of 3/32 tubing, which is perfect. It fits right in there. And I just did the custom wheel. It's still wet. I put some chrome on there, you know, with the chrome pen. And probably going to hit the handles, I don't know, black or maybe another color. I don't know yet. But that's the only thing left for the interior. So, yeah, we got that going on. And the chassis, I don't know if I'm going to leave it like that or highlight it or what. But we'll see, you know. We'll see what happens with the chassis. And I finally got the body done. Here we go. I masked the whole thing off. And let me see if I can push this back a little further and get a better view. There we go. How's that? Yeah, we did a little masking there. And I used this tape, guys. If you want a two-tone paint job, use this Tamiya vinyl tape. It's very, very flexible. I got the 2 mil and the 3 mil. And this stuff does not bleed. I mean, you can see I got a little heavy. There's a, I don't know if you can see it or not, but there's just a little like ridge line over here with the end of the tape. I'm probably going to sand that down with maybe like 1500 because now I'm going to have to tape all of this brushed metal. That's what I used right here, the brushed metal. Going to have to tape all this off and then we're going to hit the bottom portion with this pearl over here. And that's going to look pretty cool. And you can see the design I got going on here. It follows it all the way to back. There's one little mishap over here. Actually, that's a pencil mark on here, but that's okay. That's going to be covered up. That's going to be covered up with the copper anyway, so I'm not going to worry about that. So you follow the line. It goes all the way around the back panel. Swoops down a little bit over here by the door and comes back up over the hood and over here. So let me see if I can move this back a little bit so you can see. So yeah, that's what it's going to look like. So this is dry now. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to tape off that entire roof section and follow this line over here. It's going to be a little tricky, but and then we're going to hit it with the pearl and then we'll see what happens, you know. But so far, so good. I love that color, the brush metal. Really cool looking color. Love it. And the primer right here, man, my old reliable. I bought 3 cans of this online at JB Tools. Yeah, I ordered it on Monday, and it took 2 days to get here. So that was pretty good. I think it was like $7 shipping. But you guys, if you're going to paint your resin bodies, you need a primer that's going to work on resin, and this works perfectly. I mean, you got to use a high quality automotive type primer if you're going to use it on the on your resin bodies, man, because you know, I've done many resin bodies before and they all have this primer, except this time, you know, I try to get cute and I try to use that Rust-Oleum automotive primer and it just did not stick, you know, and I followed the same procedure as last time, sanded it, washed it with soap and water, rinsed it very well, let it dry, and I did nothing wrong. It's the primer. And this stuff works great on styrene also. And it's got a cool, this cool tip over here. I got to see if I could take this tip off and put it on other cans or any more rattle cans because this tip is great. It's got a fan spray on it right there. I don't know if you can see that. You can adjust it any way you want. And this stuff comes out in like a mist. And you can just give it some nice, easy coats. And I'm telling you guys, you look at this here. There is zero orange peel on it. Check that out. You can get as close as you want. It's smooth as a baby's ass. And I highly recommend this stuff. I mean, if you guys using Tamiya, that's a good primer also, you know. That's a quality primer. But if you can get your hands on this, I highly recommend this stuff. It's about like $8 a can if you buy it online. I think if you buy it at the auto parts store, it's probably like $10, $11, but it's worth every cent, man. Dupli-Color. Old reliable. For me, anyway. All right, guys, that's about it. And yeah, she's looking good. And the next video I make, maybe with any luck, we might have a finished product over here. So you guys enjoy the rest of your night and be safe and keep on building.